Hello and welcome to another episode of SportsRoom. I'm Reuben and with me here, as always, is Anirudh, Madhavan, and well, it's the Cricket World Cup going on, more like the Rain Cup going on. So there were no games, I mean, there were four games washed out this time, which meant that I was forced to watch NBA, the NBA Finals. But yeah, it was a good game anyway, so that was fun. Well, since the last episode, four matches were washed out, and that is obviously the biggest talking point this week. This is the first World Cup where more than two matches have been washed out.
Yeah.
The last one was 2003 and 1992 also there were two matches washed out. But you know what that means. It means that New Zealand might be on top of the table right now with 7 points, but then
Rain has 8 points.
So Rain finishes first for semi-finals, if that was the table. So for all the analysis we had before the tournament, nobody really talked about the Rain, nothing of that sort.
Seems to be a point everybody missed or didn't want to see, or because last year England at the same time it was very dry. June is supposedly the third driest month. And last year the whole of June they had 20 millimeters of rainfall. This time within 48 hours they have had 100 millimeters. So
yeah,
they didn't see that coming. Also the PCB chairman, Pakistan Cricket Board chairman, apparently said that in two or three of the meetings he was there at the ICC meetings, this never came up. They didn't discuss about weather managing the ground.
So it's actually that, I mean, sort of them not being prepared for this scenario. Yeah, we can't blame them after all, like you know. But we can talk about all this over here, but then there's somebody over there who's actually experiencing it there from our office, and I mean our colleague, and that's Deputy Chief of Bureau Delhi, Neeru Bhatia. And she's in Nottingham, and she happened to be there for the India-New Zealand match that didn't happen. So here's a report from her.
There's been a lot of angst over the washed out matches, with the India-New Zealand one being the latest casualty. But having said that, the ICC has explained its position that logistically it's impossible to have reserve days for every match in such a long-drawn tournament. It's 45 days of action and this rain has been unprecedented. Besides, it takes around 1,200 people per match, which includes groundsmen, staff, security, logistics, players, officials, and the whole thing to get one match organized, and including the television crew, etc. So it's a lot of money, a lot of people that need to be adjusted, and it's virtually impossible, says the ICC, to have reserve day for every match. Having said that, Saurav Ganguly, Indian captain, has talked about having full covers for all grounds, especially important grounds and in important tournaments like the World Cup. Lords has it, Eden Gardens has it, so why not Penfridge? This is Neeru Bhatia for the week.
So yeah, Neeru said, there are options of retractable roof and all that. But realistically, how is that? How is that really is that something that can really be considered?
There is one such stadium. It's in Australia. It's in Melbourne. It's called, used to be called the Docklands Stadium. Now it's called the Marvel Stadium for all you Marvel fans. So it has a retractable roof. It's 125 feet above the playing surface. Closest east to west, and but not a lot of games have been played there. It's mostly used for Australian football. And so for the Big Bash League. But it's not considered one of the great stadiums in the world. And the cost involved is a lot.
Yeah. So we have, like, for example, there's the Wimbledon where they're, you know, they have retractable roofs and all that. But there was a statistic that I was reading that it's actually pretty expensive because in Wimbledon alone, for those two courts that they had to, it was, one was about 100 million, the other cost them about 70 million. So just imagine how that would be for 11 grounds in England. So it's not something that's actually considerable, but maybe someday that might happen.
Probably, eventually. But like they're doing this in Qatar, they're doing it for the football world.
FIFA,
because Qatar, it's still too hot.
Still
so Qatar. Because they have oil money. So.
Okay, then the other option obviously is covering the entire ground.
Yeah.
So there was, I think, was it the Sri Lanka?
The Sri Lankan Cricket Board does this. They cover the entire ground, and there was recently a report about it. So apparently what they do is they get a lot of volunteers as well as people who come to see the match and daily wage labourers who cover the whole ground in about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
The pitch is covered within a minute. So after that, it helps with the drainage, and as soon, soon as the rain stops, within an hour you can start the match. But that would not probably be as successful in a country like England. You can't really ask fans to come and clean up.
Already there are so many people working over there, about 1,000 odd people here.
So the point of contention is whether you want to play while rain is going on, or whether you want to resume as soon as possible after the rain. So that's where the retractable roof and covering the
And then the other option was also keeping reserve days.
Yeah.
But is that also feasible? Already this tournament's like what,
a month and a half long tournament. Yeah.
Cricket tournament. So is reserve days another?
It's logistically, as Neeru said, it's going to be a huge headache. So many matches, some 48 matches, you can't have reserve days for each match.
Exactly.
96 days, more than 3
and
months.
But I think the semi-finals and the finals, they have reserve
days. They have reserve days, and if I'm correct, if the final is washed out and the reserve day is also washed out, they'll have to share the trophy.
Wow.
Which happened in the Champions Trophy, I think, 2006, India and Sri Lanka had to share.
Okay, so that will be a very sad World Cup, end to the World Cup then. Anyway, so like we were saying, I mean, we talk about all this happening, but there's also the fans, you know, at the same time. So I was just reading up this thing about the ICC rule when it comes to match refund. So if what I saw is that if it's less than 15 overs bowled, then it's 100%, they get 100% refund of the match fee. And if it's between 15 to 30 overs, then it's about 50% of the match fee.
Yeah.
But what I also thought is, you know, when I read that at first thing, I thought it was like, it's going to be such a big loss for the ICC, right? But then, turns out they have like this rain insurance cover. So, pity the insurance companies.
Because even if the fans get a refund, that's only the ticket fee. That doesn't include travel, accommodation.
So imagine if somebody actually goes there just to watch like two matches and they...
Also a lot of expatriates, a lot of Indian, Pakistani and Bangladesh fans who might not have fancy jobs there.
Yeah.
They put all their earnings into this, they travel and they get nothing back.
So that's basically what we had. Sadly, there's nothing much to talk about in this World Cup. But then, the first week was pretty interesting. And we also had, in this week, we had India play Australia, which was a good match for us. And then we had Australia and Pakistan. Yeah, Australia-Pakistan match was also pretty good. Pakistan gave a good fight, but...
Pakistan.
Anyway, so next we have the India-Pakistan match on Sunday.
Yeah, if that gets washed out.
No, but then they say it's going to be there, right?
Because apparently it's only this week, next week onwards it will be sunny again.
So that's at Old Trafford.
That's at Old Trafford.
Okay. So, so that's all we have from Sports Room today. Do check out our other World Cup related content, which is online in the magazine. And like we said, Neeru's over there and she's reporting for us. So thank you for joining us today and hope to see you next time.